Hi everybody, welcome to Eurochannel. Some of you have asked about penile extenders, so here it is. My review about what they do, what to expect, and problems you might run into with the different devices. My name is Stefan Buntrock, I'm a urologist and sexologist. I regularly prescribe penile extenders for treating Peyronie's disease. But of course, they may also be used for penile enlargement purposes. None of the companies I contacted wanted to send me a device for review, so I can't show you the real thing in this video. On the other hand, this puts me in a position to independently tell you what I think without being committed to any manufacturer, because my patients bring their extenders with them if they have problems with putting them on. The basic principle is more or less the same with most extenders. The penis is mounted onto a frame with extendable rods. The mounting mode differs slightly from model to model. There are some exceptions like the Phallosan 40, which uses an elastic hip girdle to pull the penis, and the Restorex that offers adjustable angles and is designed more specifically for the treatment of Peyronie's disease. Penile traction is like braces for the penis. You have to start slowly because permanent traction will feel uncomfortable in the beginning. But with time, the duration of traction has to be increased. At least 3 hours, better 6 to 8 hours a day, over a period of several months are necessary for noticeable results. For the Restorex device, less time is recommended. But generally, time is an issue with many men. The therapy demands a huge amount of commitment. In my experience, only a minority of men are willing to wear a device for that long of a period every day. Even in Peyronie's disease, where we are talking disfiguring angles with erections, many patients refuse traction therapy or don't use it every day and only for a very short time. This lack of compliance is also reflected in the published scientific studies, as recruitment was definitely an issue. What can be expected? Depending on what length you are starting on, 1 to 2 centimeters is a realistic outcome for penile lengthening. This is approximately 0.7 to 0.8 inches. In Peyronie's disease, the goal is to prevent penile shrinking, which occurs on a regular basis. If used regularly and for the prescribed duration, a significant reduction in curvature up to 50% is possible in some men. Penile girth is probably not affected by stretching. A very small study found some changes in the girth of the glands, however. Traction has been successfully used on different body parts for thousands of years in earlobes, lips, neck, etc. So there is reason to believe that it also works in the penis. Let's have a look at possible problems with the use of extenders. Often they feel uncomfortable when worn over many hours. In models where silicone bands are used to hold the penis in place, traction has to be interrupted every 2 hours. In practice, my patients very often complain that they are unable to resume their normal activities when they wear the device. As a rule, penile extenders require a certain level of manual dexterity. It sometimes requires quite some skill to maneuver the penis into the device. In my experience, extenders with a silicone band work for many. They are quite affordable and there are no fancy gadgets attached to them. The tip of the penis is placed on some kind of tray and a silicone band tightened behind the glands. However, in men with short penises, and especially in uncircumcised men with very elastic foreskin, the silicone band might not do the job as the penis slips out. In these cases, a vacuum solution such as in the Penimaster and Phallosan devices might be better. They apply a suction device on the glands and stretch from here. But especially in the Phallosan, a plastic cap has to be placed onto the glands first. A few of my patients did not succeed with this step as it was impossible for them to accomplish this task. So before buying any penis extender, it might be wise to put individual penile anatomy and manual dexterity into consideration. Problems in putting on the device will add to the burden of wearing it for many hours, thus lowering the probability for them to be used at all. If you're interested in penile enlargement or want to know more about Peyronie's disease, check out these videos. Consider subscribing to my channel and hit the Eurolike button if this video was of value to you. I will put links to the extenders I referred to in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.